John Sector 5, John Sector 5 and verse 35. The Lord Jesus Christ was speaking about John the Baptist. He said this: he was a burning and a shining light, and he were willing for a season to rejoice in his light. But I have greater witness than that of John, for the works which the Father hath given me to finish, the same works that I do bear witness of me that the Father has sent me. And the Father himself which has sent me hath borne witness of me. Ye have neither heard his voice at any time, nor seen his shape. And ye have not his word abiding in you. For whom he has sent, him ye believe not. Search the scriptures, for in them ye think ye have eternal life, and they are they which testify of me. This is the Lord Jesus Christ speaking. And ye would not come to me that ye might have life. Are you prepared to come to the Lord Jesus Christ that you might receive everlasting life? For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. I receive not honour from men, but I know you that ye have not the love of God in you. I am come in my Father's name, and ye receive me not. If another shall come in his own name, him ye will receive. How can ye believe which receive honour one of another, and seek not the honour that cometh from God only? Do not think that I will accuse you to the Father. There is one that accuseth you, even Moses, in whom ye trust. For if ye believe Moses, ye would have believed me, for he wrote of me. But if ye believe not his writings, how shall ye believe my words? You see, the whole Bible, the whole Word of God speaks of the Lord Jesus Christ, Old Testament and New Testament. In the law, we're looking at the Old Testament, looking at the Psalms, the prophets. All these books speak of the Lord Jesus Christ. And he's the one that can be your Savior this evening. I wonder, have you received the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior? He'll either be your Savior or he'll have to be your judge. You must make the decision. It's either one or the other. It's up to you. You see, many people think that God decides where we go at the moment of death. That is not right. That is not true. You and I decide our eternal destiny. And our eternal destiny is determined by what we do with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You need to understand, you and I are sinners in the sight of God when we're born into this world. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. And your soul can be saved. And that's why I'm here this evening. I want you to know that your soul can be saved by repentance toward God. That is a change of mind. Simply come to God and agree with him. Yes, I realize that I'm a sinner, but thy son has died for me upon the cross. And all you simply need to do is believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. It's a wonderful thing to know that your soul is saved and you're on your way to heaven. And it's all because of the finished work of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, when he died upon the cross and shed his precious blood that day, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness and sin. Where are you headed for all eternity? Is it heaven through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ? Because that's the only way we can ever be in heaven. He that hath the Son hath life. He that hath not the Son of God hath not life. Do you have the Son of God? Have you believed on him for your eternal salvation? You see, salvation is of the Lord. If we're ever going to be saved, we'll have to be saved by God. God does the saving. By his Son, Jesus Christ, who died upon the cross. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. In whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sin. Now, if you're interested in this, look me up, youtube.com/peace by Jesus Christ. God bless you, and thanks for listening.